of slim pickings. Open your ears and listen to what I'm saying. Women have a lot of slim pickings. The pickings for women are not as vast as the pickings for men. We are literally picking through a pile of shit when it comes to men. Let's just call a spade a spade. We are picking through men that don't equal up to what the fuck we looking for. Let's just put it out there, because I'm tired of y'all with the bullshit. Either you fine as fuck and you ain't got no motherfucking job. Either you got a job and you ugly as fuck. Either you don't have a lot of money but you got a big dick. Either we trying to pick and choose through a lot of bullshit y'all bring it to the table. You don't have a car, but you got a good heart. You got a 9-to-5 job, but you don't have bigger goals than that. We gotta listen, we trying to pick and choose the best out of a lot of bullshit. So y'all gotta cut us some motherfucking slack. We trying to get the best we can get out of a lot of shit that y'all not bringing to the motherfucking table, okay? Don't try to act like all y'all got y'all shit together. We either gotta pick a nigga that we know gonna cheat because he got money, but he financially stable. Or we gotta pick from a man who don't cheat, but all his shit ain't together. What the fuck do you expect us to do? I'm just asking. We are literally trying to solve math equations by picking the best dude that we can motherfucking pick. This shit is not, it ain't just simple dating no more. This shit literally boils down and you are literally having to solve a fucking mathematical equation to try to get a motherfucking man that's hitting on something. What do you want us to do? You love talking about it's our fault. How the fuck is our fault when half of y'all don't even equal up to a whole man? It literally takes three of y'all motherfuckers, three, to equal one. How the fuck that's our fault? We gotta get one with a big dick, one that's financially stable, and one that don't cheat. You gotta literally have three niggas to equal one. What do you?
Yes, sis. Let's call a spade, because I got time. But I want to talk to them women that while she was saying what she was saying, y'all was like, yes, sis, preach. Well, let me ask y'all a question real fast on this beautiful day. Could your son bring sis home to be your daughter-in-law? That's all I'm asking, because y'all was agreeing and clapping and cheering and all that. Can your son bring sis home, though? No, for real. Can your son bring sis home? Oh, I didn't think so. Oh, I didn't think so. Because let me tell you something. Sis talk, sitting up here talking about his slim pickings when it comes to good men. Sis, no, don't know good men. Don't no good man want no woman with no toxic attitude like that, with no toxic mindset, and no toxic vibe. So that's why sis can't find no good man, and she talk about his slim pickings out here. Men could feel like because of women like her, that it's slim pickings out here when it comes to us. And that every woman acts like that. No, every woman don't act like that. Every woman don't think like that. You understand? And even when it comes to bringing things to the table, we always talk about men don't bring this to the table. And men don't bring that to the table. Well, this is what I'm going to say in response to that. Us as women, sometimes we require men to bring things to the table that we don't have. And then sometimes when we do have those things and we require them to bring the same things to the table, we're not really humbling ourselves. Because think about the times that you couldn't bring those kind of things to the table. You understand? And would you want a man to come and be with you because you have a car and because you make 6-7 figures and because you live in a big house? No, you would not. You would want a man to come and be with you for who you are. So why should men accept us to want to be with them for the things that they have? Why don't we have the same compassion and understanding when it comes to men? That's all I'm sitting up here saying. And a good man is different from a perfect man. See, she's looking for a perfect man. Talk about it takes three men to equal a good man or whatever she said. First of all,